Hello, this is Blue Hair and Tarot. I'm going to do a read for Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. I'm going to do the astrology spread. This is going to cover relationships, guys. It's going to cover relationships, but it's a bunch of other stuff. This is a really nice spread. It turns out really good. Communication's coming in for you, Scorpio, with the Eight of Wands, Eight of Inspirations. Maybe from an air sign. Someone really wants to talk to you. For some of you, this has to do with a child. Okay, there's been a lot of healing going on in your environment. Maybe you are a healer, Scorpio. All right. All right, again, like a lot of expansion, a lot of fortune in the house of money, in the house of security, of things that you have. I think that you're going to continue to be successful and move forward in that area. Some of you guys might be traveling really soon. Some of you guys might be actually going to a healing retreat, traveling to do some healing, traveling to do some relaxing. There's just a lot of fast forward energetic movement going on for you. And it's sort of in your house with the eighth house. Some of you guys might be studying something, traveling to study. And a lot of you guys are kind of, I don't know, it's like you feel like you've been stabbed in the back, but you're actually pulling those, like you're done. Like maybe you've been stabbed in the back and you're just kind of done with that cycle and you're moving on from it. There's a major change going on with how you communicate. Maybe there's been a breakdown in communication. Maybe some of you guys are dealing with a know-it-all, and you're kind of, for some of you, you're getting away from that energy. You know, somebody who just is constantly bringing up what's wrong with you. You know, what's wrong with the relationship, what you're not doing that's good enough. And I kind of feel like you're getting away from that kind of know-it-all energy, overthinking, and moving into a place of peace and healing. So maybe there's just a breakdown in communication with a particular person and you're like, I'm out. Like, you're done. Like, it's reached its peak. It's reached its Ten of Swords. And I feel like you're moving on. You're moving towards healing. You're moving towards growth. Looks like as far as your money's going so far, it's pretty awesome, okay? Because you want a stable home. Interesting. The home life's looking good. So if this is something where there was a breakdown in communication, I'm sorry, I'm about to sneeze. It's almost like if there was a breakdown in communication with this person, Scorpio, either you start to heal it by saying, kind of getting like, you're like, I'm not doing this anymore. I'm not gonna engage in this kind of communication. I'm not doing this overthinking. I'm not getting caught in this like kind of self-sabotage, like overthinking, blaming. I don't know. There's just fear. I feel like there's a little bit of like guilt and shame put upon you and you're just getting away from it. I feel like declaring that that's no longer a part of what you want in your home. You want your home to be peaceful, collaborative. You want to build something stable and invite God in. And so I feel like this tower in which the way you were once communicating with somebody is collapsing. And maybe you guys are either making it work together. You're moving on a path towards healing. Maybe you're spending some time by yourself and away from this energy. But this declaration in general, Scorpio, is actually causing a lot of harmony in your home. There we go. A lot of harmony. And I also see you feeling really fulfilled. So some of you guys, by saying to, if you have a partner or maybe a child or somebody in your life that's just a know-it-all, you're like, or maybe you have an inner voice within your mind that's like a know-it-all, you're like, we're not doing this anymore. I'm going to be happy. I'm going to be emotionally fulfilled. I'm not playing in these ego games anymore. You've cut it off. You've cut off things like you can't be threatened by fear anymore. You're not afraid of any kind of threats of the mind. And now you're just expressing your happiness. your contentment with yourself, your contentment with maybe even this person shifts and changes because you cut out the energy. Like maybe you guys collectively decide together, like, we're not going to pick on each other anymore. We're going to heal. We're going to have a happy home here. We're not going to communicate in a way that's going to break things down and bring in more shadows and fear. We are going to rise above that. So for some of you guys, you're working this out with somebody. Others of you, because you personally decide to cut it out. Others of you, you cut it out and you start to build a lot more. Why am I like, why is my nose running right now? You're building a more happy home life. You're feeling more fulfilled emotionally. I have to like blow my nose here, Scorpio. I can't. So weird. Sorry about that, guys. So in the sixth house is your house of health, your service to yourself. Your service is to follow the High Priestess, follow the advice from above the veil, follow your truth, follow your true you. It's becoming your higher self. You are becoming your higher self. You're cutting out the lower self. You're cutting out the know-it-all. You're cutting out the monkey mind. This is really beneficial. This is really beautiful. Some of you guys are going to be single, or if you're not single, if you're in a marriage, you're going to be whole and complete regardless of what, if this know-it-all or whatever, or if it's a child, it's not going to affect you anymore. You're moving far, far away from it and you're just healing, relieving yourself of that cycle. So for some of you, it's like you're independent, even if you're, you know, even if you have a dependent, so to speak. So this transformation has been very healing. Some of you guys, some of you guys don't, you know, you guys are following your higher selves. This is a really interesting reading. I think you're confused about this person you're with, some of you. Like, should you continue to stay? I feel like you're really in a place of balancing out your energy, healing your energy, calling in your truth, calling in your higher self. I feel like you're feeling very emotionally fulfilled regardless of whether there's someone around or not, or if your significant person is working out or not. With the seven of emotions, it's like you're not quite sure what you're seeking when it comes to love. It's kind of confusing for you. I feel like you're taking such a high, like not a high path, but you're taking such a spiritual path. It's really about your movement towards healing. It's really about, or just staying put and just being in the place that you already are. Building a happy home, building a stable home, inviting God into your home. Having that joy, that union within yourself. I mean, some of you guys, I feel like, teach like how to be happy within, because people notice you in that kind of way, Scorpio. Phew. Oh my God, what is going on? Why am I sneezing like this? I'm just so confused. All right, Scorpio again, six of inspirations in the house of career. You're inspired. You're inspired. You're moving forward. There's going to be victory. There's going to be fortune. There's going to be abundance in the area of career. Something's going on in your circle of friends. Maybe you do grief work in your groups. Some of you guys maybe are moving. Some of you guys might literally be moving, and so you're moving away from, you know, groups of friends and things like that. So there's a little bit of grieving there. Oh my God. Yeah. You're inspired. Oh my God. I'm so sorry, you guys. You're inspired. You're on fire. Some of you guys, maybe there's a collapse in like in your social groups. Maybe a wish wasn't fulfilled when it comes to, you know, a particular path. Maybe there was like a block to it. Maybe there was too many know-it-alls. Maybe there was too much chaotic energy. This could be actually in your relationship as well. Or maybe groups of friends interfered with your home life. There's kind of a lot of areas here. I'm kind of getting that your main drive right now, Scorpio, with the Eight of Wands going towards healing, with the Six of Inspirations going towards the sixth house with the High Priestess, the Ten of Emotions going towards this. So it's like you're happily ever after. And this collapse, this tower in communication, is actually building a stable home for you, a stable foundation where you invite God into everything that you do in your home. You're chasing so vigorously, like so passionately, your healing, your to be your higher self, to be your best self. It's you're on fire for it. It's like happening now, kind of. If the spirit wants you to travel, you travel. If you're supposed to go to a healing retreat, you go to a healing retreat. If you're supposed to take a spiritual bath, you take a spiritual bath. Whatever it takes to just, you're inspired, you're moved. In the area of relationship or this kind of page of voices, whatever that energy is, could be a child. It could be kind of a younger person you're in relationship. Like they're not affecting you anymore. You're done. That cycle of worry, mental anguish, it's over. There's a little bit of grieving left over. Or some of you guys are doing, you know, it's like you hoped that things would work out with this person. And maybe it can, but it can't in the energy of the Ten of Swords. It can't in the energy of miscommunications and immature communications and it just left you really confused. Like, what do I do with this person? It leaves me in a state of confusion. Not sure what I want anymore. You know, if this is good for me, if this is a good option. And I feel like you kind of forfeit the whole thing to move towards your higher self, to move towards the High Priestess, to move towards your truth. And in the end, you're just completely inspired. You're on fire. Some of you guys, it is in your workplace. Like some of you guys, you're leaving a job that was kind of a mess, which is going to cause a lot of more future growth. All right. So the Tower, whenever they rebuild an old building, they must first of all destroy the old one. So there has been a collapse of some kind with a relationship, maybe with a job, maybe with a group of friends, maybe all of them. And you're just moving towards peace and healing. Okay. So it's actually a really good thing what you've been going through. Five of Cups. Okay. What hurts you blesses you. Darkness is your candle. So this is stuff that hurt you, Scorpio. This is stuff that has left you confused. This is stuff that maybe even felt like you were being stabbed in the back. And you're finally like letting it all collapse. This person might just, you know, even if they didn't, like I kind of see this person with the Page of Voices as someone who's like maybe criticizing you a lot, putting you down, finding little triggers to like kind of keep you disillusioned, kind of keep you stuck, kind of keep you confused. Maybe not on purpose. Maybe it's the energy that they have as well. And so it's either you take it over and over again, or you just allow it to leave, fall off, so that you can be free of that constant trigger, that hitting, that putting you down. It's really bad communication. This person communicates as a know-it-all. They're clever at getting at your triggers. It leaves you confused. It brings up kind of your own darkness. It makes you confused. Am I dark? Are they dark? What the heck's going on? It brings up grief, guilt, shame. And this just can't, you know, it's okay to have that stuff come up to just look at yourself, know yourself. But when it's just constantly getting poked at you, it slows you down. And so I see you running like wildfire away from it. If you need to travel, if you need to like go to a healing retreat, if you just need to be alone. And if you achieve this amazing happiness, you actually are known for somebody who is very satisfied emotionally. Yeah, and then there's this desire to know your own soul that will end all the other desires. That's your path. You know, this person keeps you in this place of feeling small with the King of Wands. Stop acting so small. You are the universe in this static motion, and you're realizing your worth. You're realizing your power. You're moving into your fire. You're burning away the veils. You're seeing your own soul, and it ends all other desires. And this person in this energy has no hook on you, you know? They have no hook on you. I'm getting my shit together. Taking a hiatus to work on self. Yeah. I love you both. Some of you guys might have other love interests. It could be this person too, or they might manipulate you with this energy. That's for some of you. For others of you, you have a lot of options in love and you're wondering, do I even need to deal with this? And that's causing you to be stuck, and it's not making it easier. For some of you, you guys might go in a different direction in love. Soul connection, okay? This is a connection between souls that recognize each other from a past life, right? One more on that one. Too much drama. Okay, so for this connection, it's not like, this has been like a trial for you. This has been a trial for you, or an initiation for you. This is a person probably from a past life. This is maybe a person who maybe put you in a love triangle, or you put them in a love triangle because there's been too much drama and you might have wanted to get out of this. I feel like if this person did put you in a love triangle, it's literally just to get your attention. They're manipulative in the way they need energy. They're immature, but they're good at it. And you're bailing. I just see you bailing to get your shit together, to work on yourself. But it's an initiation to bring you into this harmonious energy. So some of you guys are calling in a new energy where there's like this sort of major connection that really works well, because you're starting at the roots and your foundations and your expressions to express this like peace that you're finding within yourself. You're becoming your higher self. You're even balanced through all the trials, through all the initiations, through all the transitions that you go through, the transformations. You're good at it. You've kind of mastered moving through these trials, moving through these dramas, seeing them for what they are. Your desire to know your own soul ends all other desires. So you align yourself with other people and other situations that align with your soul, your truth. And so if it doesn't align with that, it's collapsing. It's moving out of the picture. So that's interesting. I'm going to do a starseed card for you. And then I got to go and like... All right. Deep love, mother's milk, birth is a portal. It's going deep. Tapping into the love that you already are. Being fed from the source, right? And birthing kind of a new dream, a new life, a new existence that's really in alignment with like the happily ever after. Being your higher self. It's your service to yourself. Creating a real, like, beautiful home. Really collaborative home life, major inspiration in the workforce. It's like whatever you want to do for a career, it's going to be very abundant. Okay, it's going to be very abundant. And you're very much on fire and going to be very victorious in whatever you see fit for you. You're burning through the veils. You're feeling whole and complete within yourself. You know how to go through transformation in a very balanced and steady way. Scorpio's looking pretty powerful for you, okay? With that, I'm going to let you go. If you'd like a personal reading, my information is down below in the description box. They start as low as $22 for a 15-minute recorded read. But there's other options down there as well. And I'm going to send you much love, Scorpio. Take care.